middle-aged couple living in a farmhouse were struggling to maintain their farm and their house and their relationship, so they decided that they needed help. But this couple were cruel and selfish people. Instead of hiring help to take care of the farm, the couple had the brilliant idea to adopt children, and the children would do their work. So, the very next day, the couple dressed in their best clothes and wore their kindest faces and hurried down to the orphanage. And the woman running the orphanage was so anxious to find the children good homes that when she saw this well-dressed, kind-looking couple, she did not question their intentions. The couple were able to adopt three beautiful daughters, who were all sisters and had wanted to stay together. The oldest girl's name was Lily, the middle girl's name was Maria, and the youngest girl's name was Beth. The first time in their lives, these three sisters were very happy with their new family. But soon, the work started. First came planting the seeds in the field. Hours in the hot sun went by, and the girls' skins were burned. The cruel woman and her husband stood close by the field with cold lemonade, and she said, "One for me, one for father, and none for the children." Next came the housework, scrubbing floors, washing dishes, and hanging the laundry. All the while in the kitchen, the cruel woman stood baking a batch of shortbread cookies. The sweet smell carried all throughout the house, and the sisters' stomachs rumbled from hunger. But still the woman said, "One for me, one for father, and none for the children." And then came time for the girls to serve dinner. Fluffy biscuits straight out of the oven, mashed potatoes with thick gravy, corn on the cob steaming with melted butter, and slices of juicy red beef. The dining room smelled like heaven, and yet as each place went around the table, they heard the cruel woman say, "One for me, one for father, and none for the children." And with that, the girls were sent to bed. Blankets had been thrown in the corner of the attic, but a terrible draft made the room still bitterly cold. So, in the silence of night, the girls crept down the stairs into the kitchen. They feasted on potatoes and beef and corn. They poured themselves glasses of lemonade while they munched on cookies, and they snickered to one another as they pulled open the drawer beneath the sink and found a box of matches. The oldest girl, Lily, struck a match and said, "One for mother." And the middle girl, Maria, struck a match and said, "One for father." And the youngest girl, Beth, tossed their corn cobs and beef fat and cookie crumbs onto the floor and said, "And none for the children." And the old farmhouse went up in a blaze as the sisters left their new home to find another, one where the mother and father would understand how to treat the children.